Travels at 186,000 miles per second.
There you go. There you go.
And the sun is 93 million miles away.
93 million miles.
Yes.
All right.
You can still feel the heat.
Well, that's the whole.
So wait. So you think we're the only ones, or we're not?
Well, I certainly do.
Is that we're the only ones? Why is that?
I certainly believe. Well, because look. First off, there's so many variables of why we're here, and they go in hundreds of thousands. Not only that, try explaining just something like DNA.
Okay.
DNA can hold more information than the universe contains. It's one of the greatest programs ever invented.
Bill, nah, this science guy.
Well, no, it's true.
You don't think DNA is something that's engineered?
That's what?
That was something that was engineered from another species?
Well, so in other words, well, who engineered the species that engineered the species?
That's the question that we all ask.
Well, the answer is God.
Yeah.
Okay, the answer is God. Look, just the fact that every bit of material in the universe, which is so gigantic, it's almost baffling to a mind, came out of nothing. Because we know the Big Bang has been proven more than once, so
yeah.
Because of cosmic
and
cosmic radiation, cosmic microwave background radiation. Okay, so we know that as a fact, and we can actually see back in time with the Hubble telescope, back to 98%. But the bottom line is that.
Good. How are you today?
The bottom line is every bit of material that came out of, that is in the universe, came out of nothing. It's the greatest magic trick ever pulled off. That in itself is just extraordinarily mind-boggling. Because we can replay, because of the red shift, blue shift, we know what's
going out.
The universe is expanding, and we know it's picking up speed, which defies physics in and of itself, right there. So,
Right, now, do you think we're the only ones because of... They say this, if we are the only ones, it's because either the other ones have already destroyed themselves, or we're the first ones.
Yeah, look, there's no evidence of anything except us.
Yeah.
Sure.
There's no evidence. I mean, I'm kind of a show me type of guy. You know, show me the evidence.
Yeah.
We do know one thing. We know that, you know, when people talk about aliens and UFOs, you know, the only place we never see a UFO, you know where it is? In outer space, where they belong. They're always in Nebraska. You know, like I always say,
they're with Dr. Crawford.
I'll believe in UFOs when a woman lands in Compton. Okay? All right, then, you know, well, no, because that thing will be stripped before, you know. No, the bottom line is this, is that, like I say, land in a metropolitan area, you know, it's always on a farm somewhere where it's, you know, a toothless farmer is going, yeah, you know, we were visited. You know, like I said, I just don't see the evidence.
You don't believe in the ancient alien astronaut theories?
Theory. I mean, it's like saying, do I believe in the tooth fairy theory?
Well, the Big Bang is a theory, too, though.
No, the Big Bang is not a theory. It's a fact. Do your homework. It's out there.
It's a theory.
It's a fact.
Yeah?
Well, it was already proven. Okay, it's proven because we have instruments that can go back in time to almost the beginning of time that picks up the cosmic microwave background radiation. That in itself proves the energy that was expelled from the Big Bang is still working. We know it's there.
Yeah.
That's evidence.
Okay? Any thought you made a trainer? Shame on you guys.
Did you believe in the parallel worlds there?
There's no evidence for it.
Yeah.
And even if there were, it's also the latest working theorems prove that even if there was, and there's no evidence for a multi-universe, even if there was, it would still have to have a beginning.
Which could have been the Big Bang?
Well, call it what you will. There's got to be a beginning, no matter which way you look at it. If we're the only universe, there's multiple.
Thanks, Albert.
See, we